begin our celebration, scene number 646, Baptized in Water.
Celebration of Easter, but this is the first Sunday of May, and our young ones already approached the statues of Blessed Mother with crowning her statues with flowers. And then we have this privilege of welcoming two beautiful girls and six young boys as they invited their parents and their grandparents and friends and relatives to join them to celebrate the happy day of their lives. So we congratulate them in a special way, and let us enter into this sacred mystery of God's love by acknowledging our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, O Virgin, all angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Thank you.
us pray. Almighty ever living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart, and they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children and to all of those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord. from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you are patient when you suffer for doing what is good, this is a grace before God. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore out our sins in his body upon the cross, so that freedom from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been healed, for you had gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
With
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold through the gate, but climbs over elsewhere is a thief and a robber. But whoever enters through the gate is a shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice. As the shepherd calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has driven out all his own, he walks ahead of them, and the sheep follow him, because they recognize his voice. But they will not follow a stranger. They will run away from him because they do not recognize the voice of strangers. Although Jesus used this figure of speech, the Pharisees did not realize what he was trying to tell them. So Jesus said again, Amen, amen, I say to you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that they might have life and have it more abundantly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Christ. Oh, once again, I wanted to extend welcome to our young people who are present here. Can you all stand up so that we can all see you? And so here we are after year of the Lord's preparation, with the help of their spiritual teachers and the support of new parents and loved ones. So this is a very special moment, and we want to thank you for helping us to appreciate what a beautiful gift these prayers, because this Eucharist. So we want you to be part of this Eucharist, and I'm in need of help as we continue with the celebration of Eucharist. So please take a seat, okay? So when I was kind of walking in and seeing them in a beautiful procession, leading a procession, I was thinking about another young boy who was also getting ready for his first communion. And that young boy, he approached his mother and asked for a special gift for his coming first communion. So he asked, "Mom, I need a bike, a red bike, as a gift for my first communion." So what the mother did was told her son, "Why don't you write a letter to Jesus? Because you are not a good boy all this time. So why don't you write to Jesus that you want the bike?" So this young boy, he went to his room, sat at his desk, and started writing the letter, "Dear Jesus, I was so good the past year, and I am dreaming to get a bike. So I want you to give me a bike, and then make sure it is a red bike also. Signed by Bobby." Then, after writing this letter, he realized that something is not good here. No, I was not a good boy. So he crumbled that letter, and he started writing a second time, "Dear Jesus, I was not a good boy over the past year, but I think I can make it a good boy. So please, provide me with this red bike." Then again, after writing the letter, he felt, you know, this is really good, this is why I'm not going to make it. So he came down to his mom and asked, Mom, "Dear mommy, can I go to our church?" The poor mom thought that, you know, this is my son, this is a nice time. Now he's going to go to the church to pray and maybe asking forgiveness for all this mischief he did. So the mother said, "Go." And this young boy ran across the street, ran to the church, got inside the church and looked around. He saw a beautiful statue of Mary like this one sitting in the church, and no one else was there in the church. So what he did, he grabbed the statue, ran back into his home, and placed the statue over his desk, and now started writing the new letter. "Dear Jesus, I stole your mother. If you want to see her again, give me the bike and make sure it is a red one. You know who I am." It's a kind of a funny little story. But this story is also maybe our story too, no? This day is so special. This day is the completion of a long journey of 6-7 years. And the parents of these young ones are hungry. You know, they brought them here for baptism. That, you know, this is long, it's a long time ago. It went so fast. Today, you are here for one reason, to show and tell Jesus how much you love him. To open your heart to Jesus. Your preparation is on. Today, you will leave it for your hand, and you will be part of a, what do you call it, a miracle. We call it the Eucharistic miracle. What is a miracle? The miracle is Jesus, who we heard in the gospel as a shepherd. He is saving us as a brave shepherd, leading us to our eternal home in heaven. But he comes to us to help us, to feed us, to assure his presence with us. And he is more uniquely present in the gift of what we call the Holy Spirit. When you receive Jesus today in the Holy Bread, it will taste like bread, it will look like bread, it will nourish your body and soul like bread, but you know who is there in that bread? Can he hear from you? What is your answer? Is there any brave one here? Bella? What are you going to see in Jesus? Better you know. Come on. She is all of them. Anybody else? Okay, Christopher?
Then their eyes were opened.
So we are receiving the resurrection Jesus. You are going to be part of this Eucharistic miracle. Not just now, when the bread and wine will be brought in and placed in the oven, and also in the symbolic of the bread and the wine in that golden chalice, what will happen? The priest will say the words of consecration. And the bread and the wine will become the body and the blood of the risen Lord. And then you will come out and you will receive Jesus. And you will say, Amen, I believe. And when you receive Jesus, what happens to you? What will happen to you? The miracle of you become a tabernacle. You see, just like a golden tabernacle. You become a tabernacle. Having Jesus, just like a Mary holding Jesus in her womb, visited Elizabeth, you will be bringing your mom and dad and your grandma and your siblings. That's a new experience. Jesus, having Jesus in your heart, in your mind, in your life. And this has to be the rest of your life, you have to remember. Because this is the one that the good shepherd has for us. The great shepherd. He is a love for sin. He wants, he loves us unconditionally. He wants us to lead us to heaven. So till we reach that heaven, he said, what a beautiful gift the minister says. So I want to thank you, the parents here. Parents who remembered there today, I want you to close your eyes for a minute and remember that first day when you were in there, you shoes. Walking all into the aisle and saying first time, Amen, I believe. And again, this should not be there last communion. That means you are taking a big responsibility, you are becoming part of the flock. Jesus says, the flock knows me. This is the place we meet of the flock. This is a gathering of the flock. Jesus' flock. Sunday after Sunday, we gather here as Jesus' flock. And Jesus sharing his word, the miracle of his word, and the miracle of his body and soul. Sometimes we wonder, do we need to go to church? If we want to be part of this flock, we want, we need to be. This is God's chosen ones. There's always a tendency to walk away from the flock. What happens? Have you seen any kind of a lamb or a sheep walking away from the crowd of that sheep? I can guarantee you that the sheep will not survive. Did you become a lamb dog for someone? No. We don't want to be destroyed and perished. We need to stay together as one flock. We need the good shepherd. And we celebrate today this community. The sacrificial love shared by our good shepherd. So once again, congratulations to you, dear ones. Remember, this is your special day. Beautiful celebration is going to happen. Your family is going to be always with you. They are going to take pictures to keep that memory alive. No. But let us also keep this memory of the day of five. First, the courage to say yes to Jesus. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you. understand the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, life everlasting. Amen. Gathered together in the Lord's house, we trust in Him to surround with goodness and kindness all those for whom we pray.
For all Christian leaders, that they may be true shepherds to the people of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who hold public office, that they serve generously, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For parents, teachers, priests, and other leaders, that they may be true shepherds to those in their care, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the repose of the soul of Rhonda Vaughn, for whom this Mass is specially offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For each other, that all of us may realize that we can imitate the Good Shepherd by the concern we show for others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Today we especially pray for our first communicants, that through the guidance of the shepherds entrusted with their care, that they may always hold the one true faith in their hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pause to also silently pray for those intentions we hold in the quiet of our hearts, and those inscribed in our books of intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Heavenly Father, you sent Christ your Son among us that we might have life and have it to the full. Help us to listen to His voice so that He can guide us along the path of His life. We ask this through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 702, Hail Mary, Gentle Woman.
Thank you.
prayer, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours and the acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy
church. Grant that we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these past mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to pray the Lord, but in this time above all, to God, you and the most glorious living Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with the angelic host, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. incarnation of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving his holy living sacrifice. You keep in mourn the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession your presence will lie, one faith and faith. May we sacrifice of reconciliation, we pray, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. We need to convert in faith and charity your Christian church and all, with your servant Francis of Assisi, and the provision of all of which all authority, and in all people, your Son has gained the for you. Listen graciously to the praise of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, of the all brothers and sisters, to all who have pleased you, their passing from this life, especially on the give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory, Christ, O Lord, to whom all good things come. Who came and will be, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
hymn is number 366, Lord, Who at Thy First Eucharist.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
May you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional hymn is number 551, He is the Lord.
Thank you.